low spin complex of D6 in an octahedral field will have the following energy. Delta naught is the CFEC in an octahedral field and P is the electron pairing energy. So these are the options students. ये सवाल सिंगल ऑप्शन करेक्ट कैटेगरी का है एंड इसका आंसर है ऑप्शन नंबर बी. सो लेट अस सी द डिटेल्ड सॉल्यूशन फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. सो स्टूडेंट्स रिमेंबर दैट फॉर एन ऑक्टाहेड्रल कॉम्प्लेक्सेस क्रिस्टल फील्ड स्टेबिलाइजेशन एनर्जी इज इक्वल टू 0.4 इंटू पी प्लस 0.6 इंटू क्यू इंटू डेल्टा नॉट प्लस एन इंटू पी वेयर पी इज द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन एन T2g ऑर्बिटल and Q is the number of electron in the EG orbital and N is the number of electron pairs. So let's see how the d orbital splitting takes place in an octahedral field. So in a free state, all the orbitals of the central metal atom are degenerate. As ligands approaches to the metal ion, then the repulsion between the ligand orbital and the metal d orbital takes place so that the energy of the d orbital starts increasing. In an octahedral field, ligands approaches along xyz axis. Therefore, the d orbital of the metal ions whose lobes are along the axis will experience more repulsion, whereas the d orbitals of the metal ions whose lobes are in between the axis will experience lesser repulsion. Therefore, the degeneracy of the d orbital gets lost and the d orbital splits into two set of orbitals. One is a triply degenerate orbital, that is called as T2g orbitals, and another is EG orbital. So here in T2g orbital, dxy, dyz and dxz orbitals are there. Their lobes are in between the axis. And in EG orbital, dx square minus y square and dz square orbitals are there. Their lobes are along the axis. So this is the barycenter. So this energy is higher than the barycenter. So this energy is 0.6 delta naught. And over here, this energy is below to the barycenter. So this is a minus 0.4 delta naught. Correct. And the total energy, if you add, you consider by magnitude, then this will be the delta naught. So delta naught is the crystal field stabilization energy of d orbital. When electron occupies T2g level, it will accompany by the loss of energy. Okay, that's why we are given with a negative sign. Therefore, the formula for CFEC calculation is minus 0.4 into the number of electrons in the T2g orbitals plus 0.6 into number of electrons in the EG orbital into delta naught plus N into P, that is number of electron pairs and pairing energy. Clear? So students, remember that the low spin complexes are formed by the strong field ligand and strong field ligand splits the T2g and EG orbitals to the more extent. So the energy of separation between T2g and EG is more. So in case of these complexes, the pairing energy of electron is less than the delta naught. So therefore, electron, instead of going into EG, it gets paired up in a T2g. So therefore, in D6 configuration, electron will be first filled like this, then like this, like this. Instead of going into EG, it occupies here because this energy separation is more. So D6 configuration has this type of arrangement. So this type of arrangement is T2g 6, EG 0. So from the electronic configuration T2g 6, EG 0, we can conclude that P is equal to 6, Q is equal to 0 and N is equal to 3. So from the formula, we'll write, on substituting the values, we'll get CFEC as minus 12 divided by 5 into delta naught plus 3P. Therefore, option number B is the correct answer. That's it. Thank you very much, students, for listening. If you like our efforts, please like the video, share it with your friends and subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook as well as Instagram. See you all in the next video. Thank you.